Hey folks, this is Bardic Dragoon. Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect. When we last left off, we had landed on planet Vermeier here, had a nice heart-to-heart talk with Rex, and pretty much learned that, well, we kind of found Saren, apparently. And these Isolarians are going to help us, are going to get us involved in their assault plans to take him down. So, yeah, that sounds good.
Thank you for speaking with the Krogan. The assault on Saren's base will be difficult enough as it is.
I assume that means you've come up with a plan.
Of sorts. We can convert our ship's drive system into a 20-kiloton ordnance. Crude, but effective.
Nice. Drop that nuke from orbit, and Saren can kiss his Turian ass goodbye.
Unfortunately, the facility is too well fortified for that. We'll need to place the bomb at a precise location.
Where do we take the nuke, and how do we get there?
The bomb must be taken to the far side of the facility. Your ship can drop it off, but we'll need to infiltrate the base, disable the AA guns, and pacify any ground forces first.
You want us to go in on foot? We don't have enough men.
We won't be able to meet their force head on.
Definitely not, but I think we can work around that. I'm going to divide my men into three teams and hit the front of the facility. While we've got their attention, you can sneak your shadow team in the back.
It's a good idea, but your people are going to get slaughtered.
We're tougher than we look, Commander. But it's true. I don't expect many of us will make it out alive. And that makes what I'm going to ask even more difficult. I need one of your men to accompany me, to help coordinate the teams.
You expect me to commit one of my people to your command?
We are all soldiers by trade. If your people are not prepared to face such a risk, would you really want them by your side?
He's right, Commander. We can't do this without both teams at their best. I volunteer.
Not so fast, LT. Commander Shepard will need you to arm the nuke. I'll go with the Solarians.
With all due respect, Gunnery Chief, it's not your place to decide.
Why is it that whenever someone says, with all due respect, they really mean kiss my ass?
Who would be better suited to the mission?
Either of these two will do, Commander. Both seem willing to sacrifice their lives if necessary, though if we are lucky, such sacrifices won't be required.
Okay. So, to be completely honest, this decision here doesn't make much of a difference as far as I can tell, other than when you're doing your infiltration thing, you won't have one of them available, and, well, honestly, considering they're leading troops into a full-on frontal assault, honestly, the soldier more than the sentinel seems like a good option.
Williams, you'll accompany the captain. No heroics, understood?
Aye, aye, Commander.
I'll have the ordnance loaded onto the Normandy and brief your crew on its detonation sequencing. Do you have any questions before we go, Commander?
I'm ready when you are, Captain.
Excellent. Then if you'll excuse me, I need to prepare my men.
Well, this is it. Don't do anything stupid while I'm gone, LT. You too, Commander.
We'll be fine. You'll see.
Yeah, I just... Good luck.
Is there something you want to say, Chief?
I don't know. It's just weird. Going under someone else's command. I've got used to working with you. All of you.
Don't worry. We'll see you on the other side.
I know. It's been an honor serving with you, Commander.
Whatever happens, everyone just keep shooting. We go in hard, hit them harder, and we'll be the only damn thing that comes out the other side.
You bet, Commander.
You all know the mission and what is at stake. I have come to trust each of you with my life, but I have also heard murmurs of discontent. I share your concerns. We are trained for espionage. We would be legends, but the records are sealed. Glory in battle is not our way. Think of our heroes. The Silent Step, who defeated a nation with a single shot. Or the Ever Alert, who kept armies at bay with hidden facts. These giants do not seem to give us solace here, but they are not all that we are. Before the network, there was the fleet. Before diplomacy, there were soldiers. Our influence stopped the Rachni, but before that, we held the line. Our influence stopped the Krogan, but before that, we held the line. Our influence will stop Saren. In the battle today, we will hold the line.
Good luck, Commander.
I hope we will meet again.
Alright, so, time for our dice roll. Who are we taking with us? 2 and 1. Okay, so that's 1, 2, what? Huh. It almost feels where, I don't know if maybe the way that I'm deciding to distribute when I do the dice rolls this, that those two end up being the most common results somehow. I mean, I guess it makes sense the tech characters do get an unfair advantage since they get 2 chances to get chosen, but still, it just feels really weird that these two are the ones that keep ending up on my squad. Not that I'm complaining, it works well. Compliments the whole Vanguard thing. Let's look at our matching outfits. We look good on the battlefield.
Comm check, do you read me, Commander?
It's fine. Let's move.
Good. We'll start our push. We'll try to make it to the AA guns, but it might be up to you to finish the job. And Commander, if you see any way to undermine their defenses, we could definitely use the help.
Okay, so you got a point. Let's see where we're at. Ooh, that is quite a jump in duration. Oh, actually, and barrier bonuses. Okay, yeah, sure. I really don't know what I'm doing with these. I'm kind of at the point I don't know what I'm doing with any of these characters. Boost that up to 9%. Yeah. Yeah, to at least get him assault training. That seems like a good goal to reach for. And I'm already leveled up here. Okay. So, this little segment of the game is actually kind of interesting.
Shadow is on the ground. Repeat, Shadow is on the ground. Chief Williams, with Igor team. Manovai, Tieto teams, move. Time to get some attention.
All right. Why am I trying to go for shift as tactical pause? That's, I think in the later games, that's what it is when you play them on PC. All right. Shift is run. Okay. It's been like a week since I last played this. How come I cannot remember the controls? Whatever. Anyway. Oh, hey, they got sniper up there.
Right. Manovai is under coordinated crossfire. Check for long-range turrets helping the Geth target.
But yeah.
Enemy sighted.
Hi. And you know what? Throw you on the ground. Aha! Sniper up there. If you don't mind. There we go. But yeah, this section, we're basically, I mean, the little speech beforehand when we were talking with Kirihi, not his speech, which it's moments like that I kind of wonder, what do the alien languages actually sound like in this game? Like, if you were to hear them not through the universal magical translator that everything has, because of course it does, what would it sound like talking to these characters? Where are you? I see a dot. Oh, you know what? He's not threatening us right now. Let's do the first of 3 things we can do to help out Kirihi and them. Because, yeah, there's 3 different things you can do as you're making your way into Saren's facility here. To try, or to help out the Salarians to kind of keep them alive. Yeah, that was incredibly stupid of me.
Take out those hostiles!
What hostiles?
The perimeter reminds me of where I grew up with Palamon. Minus the Geth.
There we go. Took me a moment to remember what the heck the button for heal was. Because I was incredibly stupid.
Something scrambled, they're targeting. You got a shot. Chief Williams, take the heat off Manavai.
Okay. So that's the first thing, of course, to help out in the battle here. And alright. Pardon me. You can get rid of that shield for us. Alright, synthetics also take damage from overload. Or, well, I say synthetics, but really the only synthetic enemies that you fight in this game are the Geth, but yeah. Okay. No, that's not. I don't hear that. Okay, if I remember correctly, we want to take the long route. Stop that! We actually want to go this way. That's not right. This way? No. That way! Okay. I had to relocate myself there for a moment. But yeah. Lift? Oh yeah, sure. Alright. I love that. It's just one of those things that just feels really good. Just, okay, line up the shot and disintegrate them with overwhelming firepower. Okay. There must be something right in front of me here, according to my radar. They're behind the rocks, aren't they? Hello? Okay, it says there's an enemy on the map, but... Oh, I've also gone the wrong way. Damn it. Yeah, this place is a little bit twisty and windy of a path, so... You know, that happens. There we go. This is where we want to go, I hope. I don't know, as you kind of saw when we were looking at the map, it all leads into the same area for this next immediate area. There's some branching from there. But, yeah. For the moment, we're just all leading to the same spot. Everything on the radar. We have... Ah, rocket drone. There we go. Yo, Garrus. Rockets are not for eating.
That's it. Magnum attack.
Keep yourself alive, man. Actually, I probably was unnecessary to heal him.
They're calling SAT strikes. Dieto, watch for comm stations. William, can you see anything?
Yeah, you got dampening. Neural shock, which won't do any good against a drone. By the way, you can actually crouch to improve your aiming, if you improve the spread of your aiming reticle. No, there's more of you up there. Come on. Oh. Alright. Need to get you floating. Because for some reason, Krogan regeneration doesn't work when they're floating. And I think he just fell out of bounds of the map. I mean, technically not, but he can't reach us and we can't reach him. He's still technically on the map, if I remember correctly. Alright. Oh, wait, no. I didn't fall completely off the map. You can still get to him. So we'll deal with him in a moment. Yeah, at least if I remember correctly. Had a kit over there. Hey, buddy. Right. No, you're not moving from that spot, it seems like, so...
Aircraft heading to perimeter stations to recharge. Bunker up before they come back.
Oh, hey, Geth Destroyer. Hi. No. No, you are not. Booyacha! I'm already dying and disintegrating, okay? Okay, the last thing. Yeah, we want to head for the refueling platform. It's going to be the last thing we can do to help out the Galarians here. So that's this way, I think. Yeah, because as I said, there's aircraft refueling. I think they're talking about drones rather than like aircraft. Oh god. Oh god, I forgot my keys! My fingers became misaligned for a second there. Get up, Garrus. Oh, there's still something else shooting us. Okay, fine. You are another cell phone. Oh, you just had to sidestep there. And yet somehow it survived that giant explosion. Okay, can you get up now, Garrus? Hey, buddy. How you doing? Doing good? Good. Stop being an idiot. Alright. No, it's not what it... Stop it. Okay. Now if we just ride this over to here, that'll take us to the actual research facility. Or, well, by ride this, I mean walk along this path, but, you know, whatever. Ride does sound a lot more interesting, doesn't it? So, the Solarians are pretty much going to survive now, I think. Remember quickly how those affect the outcome of this mission, at least. It's been a while since I've played this one. Well, since I played this part of this game. I mean, I was just playing the game about a week or two ago, and the last time I was recording, so, you know. Whatever on that. Ow! Okay, your laser sight was not pointing at me, what the heck. And... actually, no. What we want. Switch out your weapon. Actually, you keep yourself alive. Actually, hold on a minute. Alright. Oh shit, Krogan! Gaiden! Whoa, what the heck? Okay, so you're pretty much going to be ignoring my damage, so let you down. Okay. There we go, neural shock. Alright, and are you guys still over there? Nope, you seem to be dead. Okay, good for you. Alright. So oh, that actually went a little bit...
must be getting close. Hold the line, men. Hold the line.
Rail extension B. Do I have a rail extension B on this thing? I know I've got a rail extension. I've got a rail extension B. And hammerhead rounds, because I don't think they've replaced the next tier of hammerhead rounds that started showing up yet. Scanner 5. I just assume that it's been a while since we've checked this kind of stuff. Okay, you're right. Okay. Sniper rifle, photon round 5, so get that photon round 6, and rail extension, there we go. Okay. Rail modulator 6, okay. For as good as we're going to get for the moment. And back into the menu, apparently. Okay, so Kaiden, what do we know about you? I think the main thing you bring to the team here are... as far as abilities, that might actually help out. As much as I'm not a fan of the stasis ability, it might actually help out. With the usual silk training, and... alright, I want to get you to lift. Nexus 5 Omnitool might be useful. First of all. Nope, okay. Shield bonus, tech cooldown bonus. That looks a lot better for that's barely a boost for you, so. And again, you're mostly our tech guy, so we'll just give the RC a little Omnitool. There we go. Huzzah! Okay, so now we go over to that door, go inside, and start doing this mission for real. Because, you know, this was all just the practice phase of the mission. As you remember correctly, this next room is a bit on the dangerous side. And I don't remember at all, because this is not a room, this is a bridge.
Got access to base security. Should be able to cut the alarms from here. Might even be able to trigger alarms on the far side of the base. It'll clear the guards out for us, but they might be too much for Williams and the Solarians to handle.
Yeah, they've got enough.
Just disable the alarms. We can handle any guards inside.
Okay. So. And then you notice... thankfully, the radar actually penetrates behind those walls. Give us a bit of a better idea of where's a good place to start. In this case, take out our guns. Didn't mean to heal. You gotta remember the button to actually take out guns on their own. And... no, you get rid of that. Geth Destroyer is the real threat here. So let's go ahead. Actually, let's see what happens if we... oh god. Gaiden! Please get that thing away from me. I do not like having giant gun-toting things right in my face. It's a little disconcerting. Alright. Shields to regenerate. Okay, that's done. Where are you? Yeah, that way we'll have our backs to an enemy. Oh, shock trooper. They're hardly worth the effort. Haha!
Captain Sats
Oh yeah, by the way, if you hadn't noticed, some of the enemies labeled as indoctrinated are Solarians. That will make sense here in a few moments, I think, if I remember correctly how this plays out. Oh! Crates! A juggernaut! Booyacha! I can shoot my own rockets! Okay. That cleared up this room for the moment. And I think one of these things has some stuff we can take. Or maybe I'm completely wrong. That works too. A sorry intel report. That sounds like it could be useful. I have experience points on a codex entry I'm not going to read. Maybe it wasn't as useful as it sounds. Okay. Accidentally hit R while I was hitting E.
Hello? Is someone out there?
Hello? Kind of feels.
We don't want them to bunker up. Draw them out.
Valerian intel report. Let me guess. Another codec and experience points, of course. You know, it can't be like a side quest or a prompt kind of explaining what's happening here. Of course not. That would make life too easy. 6, 8, 6. Katana. Or did that say Katana 7? Stabilizer 5, 6. Oh yeah, Katana 7! Yes, baby. Which actually gives us 2 weapon mods now. So in addition to our ammo mod, we now have a weapon mod, or a second weapon mod slot. Because you start getting those at tier 7 weapons. So, let's see. Oh, what the heck? Let's just extend that rail way farther than it should be. And I think by now I can only get one shot out of my gun before things just go horribly wrong. And nope. Okay. Oh, hello, Stiletto 6. There we go. That's the upgrade. Unfortunately, not 7 yet, so that stinks. Ooh. Dunami 7, which gives us a second. I think rail extension is a good one to have. Breaker 7. Yes, please. And improve weapon stability. Alright. Making some good progress here. Okay, let me see if I remember correctly how this place works. Oh, hey! Missed this door here. Too busy getting, you know, killing innocent, mind-controlled drones, indoctrinated people. Okay, I heard someone in here. We got Delirium.
Oh, you're not a Geth. And you're not wearing a lab coat. I guess I'm glad to see you. Lieutenant Gonto Imnes of the 3rd Infiltration Regiment, captured during recon. I assume the fleet was called in to destroy the base?
The transmission wasn't clear. The fleet's not coming.
I see. Then you must be the infiltration team. I know the captain. He will want this facility destroyed. My team was altered, indoctrinated. He knew about the breeding grounds. But the indoctrination is a greater threat, and far more horrifying. I watched good people reduced to mindless husks. It was anything like that. Others died during the experiments. I envy them.
Do you know anything about the experiments they were conducting?
They were studying indoctrination. Symptoms, progress. Saren uses it to control his people, but I don't think he fully understands it. I don't know much else. I just saw what it did to the others. Turned them into empty husks. I can't end up like that. Please, let me out.
I'm opening your cell, but then you're on your own.
Don't look back and hope to outrun the blast, hmm? A better chance than I had before you showed up. Thank you, humans. And good luck. You'll need it.
No threat here, Commander. Are they even aware of us?
Why did Saren do this? There's just no reason.
Leave them. Let's get moving.
I wish something could be done. I really do.
Yeah, but we don't know what that indoctrination stuff does. We let them out, they could attack us. And to just outright slaughter them, I mean, I guess considering we're about to blow this whole facility up, if we leave them in there, we're sending them to their death just as easily. You know what, yeah. Let's go do the not, no, let's not. Let's not do the quote-unquote merciful thing. Let's just leave them alone. I don't know. Alright. Okay. Figure something called the lab would have people in it, but I guess not. Oh, hey, Turian Intel report. I'm sensing a theme here. Maybe I might want to read those codex entries. It seems like those might be the research results on what indoctrination does to different species. Or am I the only one getting that sense?
What do you want? I told you everything. Who are you? Alliance, right? I knew someone would come. It tried to break me, but it couldn't. I shut it out.
Slow down. I need to know where you came from.
Private Mano Savat of the 3rd Infiltration Regiment STG, man. Captured while on reconnaissance 6 days ago. Glad to answer, man. Never any questions from these bastards. Just whispers and poking and cutting. I'd say anything to get out and get some payback. That's not too much to ask, is it? A little payback?
What did they do to you, soldier?
Experiments, but I don't know what for. The effect of incessant whispering on my shortening temper? Who knows? I just need out.
Something's not right here, Commander.
Setting him free could endanger the mission.
No. No! I need to get out. This room is too small and it keeps talking and I really want to get out of here and get some work done. I need to get out. Let me out.
I can't take that chance.
Can't take that chance. No chance. I need to do what it says. I have to. Let me out. Let me out! Let me out! Let me out! Let me out!
Okay. This doesn't seem like something good, whatever is happening here. Let's not dwell on this for too much longer here. Tells me that if I'd let him out, we would have had this, whatever that's happening with these guys here on our hands. I.e. people trying to shoot us that are really no threat. I suppose really isn't, you know, that you could do so much worse, but, yeah. I already have maxed out metagel. That was useless. Hello, what's back here? Anything here? Okay. Nami Breaker 6. Oh. Breaker 6. No, Striker 7 and Hammer 7. Please tell me those are good. Get everybody on board with the 3 mods. Wow, that's a pretty decent cut. It's like a 25% cut in power. No. How about you, Garrus? Oh, wait, I already have something with the 7 on it for your sniper rifle. Never mind. Scratch that. Don't need to worry about it. Okay, apparently I skipped something. I guess I was supposed to take that elevator. Boys and girls, what's up here? That's a husk. I mean, at this point, I suppose I shouldn't be too surprised if those have been shown up where Saren's minions are.
Where are the guards?
Wait.
Where is Saren?
That's a Krogan scientist. Well, that's not what I would have expected to see, that's for sure.
No. Stay back. This is important work. This is the glorious salvation of my species.
I was experimenting on husks, creating a genophage cure. I am genuinely curious. Incendiary rounds and polonium rounds. I guess those are useful. Fusion containment cell. There's a door there. Ah, Geth fleet report. You seem useful. So, Garrus, get yourself, pull yourself together, man. Ooh, they weren't kidding about hard decryption here. Not. Massive Geth assault. That sounds like it could be bad. Phoenix 6 and another army tool. Well, got some interesting tools here from, this visit. Oh, and cryo rounds. Don't care. Ration. So I guess that at least gives us a better cooldown. Yeah, that's a good idea. On this side we have. Well, no, that's doing you any good. Or you. Oh, that's great. Alright. Oh, that other door was locked. But I think if I remember correctly, you actually have two ways you can come into this facility. Either sneaking in or burst down the door like I did. I really kind of forgot about that and just went the way that seemed the most sensible. And so the other door that was locked is the how you come in, if or where you come into the labs if you sneak in. Oh, hi! Mind. And these enemies just get easier and easier the more I actually try and use my powers like an intelligent person.
Don't shoot! Please, I just want to get out of here before it's too late.
Let's hear it. Who are you and what do you want?
Ranathanoptis, neurospecialist. But this job isn't worth dying over, or worse. You think the indoctrination only affects prisoners? Sooner or later, Saren will want to dissect my brain, too.
I thought this was a breeding facility.
Not this level. We're studying Sovereign's effect on organic minds. At least that's what I assumed. Saren kept us in the dark as much as possible.
You helped him and you don't even know why?
I didn't have the option of negotiating. This position is a little more permanent than I had expected. But I can help you. This elevator behind me goes to Saren's private lab. I can get you in. See? Full access. All of Saren's private files. Are we good? Can I go?
What were you studying here?
It's that ship, Sovereign. It emits some kind of signal. Undetectable, but it's there. I've seen the effects. Saren uses it to influence his followers, to control them. It's called indoctrination. Direct exposure to the signal turns you into a mindless slave, like the Salarian test subjects. But there's collateral damage, too.
What do you mean by collateral damage?
Sovereign's signal is too strong. Spend too much time near the ship and you feel it, like a tingle at the back of the skull. It's like a whisper you can't quite hear. You're compelled to do things, but you don't know why. You just obey. Eventually, you just stop thinking for yourself. It happens to everyone at the facility. My first test subject was the man I replaced. Now I just want to get out of here before it happens to me.
I'm gonna blow this place to hell and gone. If you want to make it out alive, you better start running.
What? You can't... But I'll never... Oh!
You enjoyed that.
I did. I did enjoy that. Yes, Kay did. I do have a sadistic streak. How did you tell? Alright. Wait for the gap. Gap is not coming. Oh, crap. Oh, well. Let's throw some Omni Gel at it. Yeah. We're dealing with tier 7s now. We don't need your tier 5 stuff. Actually, any information on her research computer? No. Oh, that stinks. Alright, so now up to Sarah's private labs. I'm sure we'll find something interesting there. I don't know if it'll help us destroy the facility, but I'm sure it will be interesting. So, what do you guys think on this? Either one of you? Nothing? Okay, cool. Whatever.
Commander, look over here. It's another beacon. Like the one on Eden Prime.
I don't know if I can take that chance. I mean, I was out for like a good day or two when we did that last time. Also, it doesn't hit the beacon to communication again. But...
this whole base out.
So, well, hey, new interface up there. What's going on? I mean, I guess I took this one better than the last one, at least.
This is not good.
You are not Saren.
What is that? Some kind of VI interface?
Rudimentary creatures of blood and flesh. You touch my mind, fumbling in ignorance, incapable of understanding.
I don't think this is a VI.
There is a realm of existence so far beyond your own, you cannot even imagine it. I am beyond your comprehension. I am Sovereign.
Sovereign isn't just some Reaper ship Saren found. It's an actual Reaper.
Reaper, a label created by the Protheans to give voice to their destruction. In the end, what they chose to call us is irrelevant. We simply are.
The Protheans vanished 50,000 years ago. You couldn't have been there. It's impossible.
Organic life is nothing but a genetic mutation. An accident. Your lives are measured in years and decades. You wither and die. eternal, the pinnacle of evolution and existence. Before us, you are nothing. Your extinction is inevitable. We are the end of everything.
There is an entire galaxy of races united and ready to face you.
Confidence born of ignorance. The cycle cannot be broken.
Cycle? What cycle?
The pattern has repeated itself more times than you can fathom. Organic civilizations rise, evolve, advance, and at the apex of their glory, they are extinguished. The Protheans were not the first. They did not create the Citadel. They did not forge the mass relays. They merely found them. The legacy of my kind.
Why would you construct the mass relays, then leave them for someone else to find?
Your civilization is based on the technology of the mass relays. Our technology. By using it, your society develops along the paths we desire. We impose order on the chaos of organic evolution. You exist because we allow it, and you will end because we demand it.
They're harvesting us, letting us advance to the level they need, then wiping us out.
What do you want from us? Slaves? Resources?
My kind transcends your very understanding. We are each a nation. Independent, free of all weakness. You cannot even grasp the nature of our existence.
Where did you come from? Who built you?
We have no beginning. We have no end. We are infinite. Millions of years after your civilization has been eradicated and forgotten, we will endure.
You're not even alive. Not really. You're just a machine, and machines can be broken.
Your words are as empty as your future. I am the vanguard of your destruction. This exchange is over.
Commander, we got trouble.
Lay it on me, Joker. I love bad news.
That ship Sovereign? It's moving. I don't know what you did down there, but that thing just pulled a turn that would shear any of our ships in half. It's coming your way, and it's coming hard. You need to wrap things up in there fast.
This console is shot. Orders, Commander?
We'll head for the breeding facility. Time to blow this place to hell.
Right, Commander. I'll meet you there. Joker out.
All right. I think we touched a nerve. Pissed off the giant sentient spaceship. Well, it's been quite a bit of content on this video. I think this is a good place to stop. So, tune in next time where I guess we're gonna go set an improvised nuke and blow the hell out of this place. Sounds fun if you ask me, but I have a slight sadistic side that we just learned, so, you know, maybe that's just me. Anyway, until then, as always, later, folks.